Welcome back to our About Seafood YouTube channel. Today we have a unique guest. We're going to be branching out a little bit from the realm of health and nutrition, and we are going to be talking about sustainability with a true expert. We have Laurel Bryant. She works with NOAA, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. And within NOAA, there is a division of fisheries. Laurel has been with this group for 25 years. So Laurel, tell us just a little bit about your role within NOAA.
Well, thanks Jennifer for having me and for bringing in the sustainability side of the conversation when it comes to seafood. We have a real story to tell, getting people to understand just how far the United States is in terms of leading sustainable seafood.
Let's start by laying the groundwork of that word sustainable. We hear it a lot in the food world. Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit about how you define sustainability as it relates to seafood and NOAA fisheries.
Very good question, and you're right. Sustainability means a lot of things, and I think it's continuing to evolve. Fundamentally, for NOAA fisheries, sustainability means production that is done in an environmentally responsible way. People also need to understand that sustainability, it really is a triple bottom line. Because not only do you need to take into account the environment and the resource itself, but you also have to think about the social and the economic sustainability. If you really don't have those three things, you're not going to have a sustainable fishery.
Could you describe the main tenets of how fish are regulated here in the U.S.?
We regulate wild capture fisheries primarily under the idea that every stock or complex of fish is allowed an annual catch limit. There's only so much that fishermen are allowed to take out. And more importantly, we are monitoring that resource all the time. Things are changing in the ocean at all times. It's not always overfishing that gets a fishery overfished. There's a lot of environmental changes. Mm-hmm. If you want sustainable seafood from wild capture fisheries, it is not a destination. It is an ongoing journey of scientifically monitoring and adjusting, and making certain that if all of a sudden you've got some overfishing going on or a change in that stock, that you modify that fishery to reduce take. Other times you may see a bumper crop of recruitment and new fish coming in, so you get to raise that annual catch limit. The point is, it's got to be a very dynamic process,
right,
that is transparent, held accountable, and enforced. And that's really what we have in the United States, and that's why it's working so well.
And that really underscores the limitations of, for example, one of those cards that's printed out once and it shows, you know, red, yellow, and green fish in different categories. Fisheries management is constantly changing. It's very dynamic, like you said. So those cards go out of date and are no longer accurate very quickly.
Yeah.
What is the role of science in NOAA's management?
NOAA Fisheries is a science agency, and we refer to it as science-based fisheries management. From wild capture fisheries and all the data that you need and the collection of that to really help identify the health of the resource, to aquaculture practices, all based on environmental sciences. You have to understand that the United States, we really have the most robust fisheries and environmental laws that guide all production.
Let's talk a little bit about that term aquaculture, because even though it's been around forever,
thousands of years,
I think people are so much more comfortable with the concept of, you know, farm fresh vegetables, farm raised, you know, chickens and cows. That all makes sense to people. But
yeah,
even though seafood aquaculture has been around for so long, it's a little bit harder, I think, for some consumers to envision. Can you define aquaculture in a couple of the most common types?
You're absolutely right. We've got the iconic vision, mm-hmm, of farmer and the barn and the cow and the chickens. And we have the iconic vision of the fisherman and the yellow slicker. So we have not done a good job in telling that story. Fish farming, there's a lot of different ways. There is onshore, and there's nearshore, and there's offshore. The thing for people that they don't understand and appreciate is that fish farming is also highly technical and scientifically intense. So I think we've got to get the face of the fish farmer out there,
mm-hmm,
because these are incredibly intense operations, and really environmentally astute and scientifically dependent.
When it comes to sustainability, farm-raised seafood and wild-caught seafood actually work together. They're not in competition, but I don't think a lot of people understand that. I think it's been presented as sort of an either-or dynamic. Mm-hmm. Can you talk about kind of the relationship between the two?
Absolutely. As we begin to understand how important seafood is to our nutrition and our health, we should be eating more seafood. This country is under in terms of its seafood consumption. Mm-hmm. But that consumption, the only way that we're going to be able to do that is by adding aquaculture to the supply. Mm-hmm. Globally, when you look at the wild capture harvest, it has been flat for over 20, 25 years. Mm-hmm. The extra amount of seafood, it's going to come from aquaculture. Mm-hmm. So I think my overall message for people is eat more seafood.
I do still see even healthcare professionals sometimes recommending maybe wild caught exclusively over farm raised. I think there's some misinformation about the nutrition value and that there may be some meaningful difference between the two when in fact there's not.
There's not. And I really hope we can get the nutritionists and the doctors to start thinking bigger.
Mm-hmm. NOAA has a robust database of seafood sustainability information on your website, fishwatch.gov. It's available for families, healthcare professionals, and really has some unique advantages over a printed out stagnant piece of information like a card. Can you tell us a little bit about the website and what's available there?
Absolutely, and thank you for asking the question. Fishwatch is really kind of our number one effort as a little science agency that does a lot of geeky things to try to simplify this very complex story,
yeah.
Right? It's a lot to understand and take in. It doesn't lend itself to a card or some simple bumper sticker message. Fishwatch provides an understanding of, you know, kind of what's the habitat impact, what's the current population level, what's the rate of fishing, those kind of key points of information that somebody wants to know in terms of its sustainability profile.
One of the points of confusion that I think exists for people, whether they're at the seafood counter or in a restaurant, is that they have to pull up information on site and try to sort out what fish is sustainable when they're trying to decide what to buy or what to order. But what I'm hearing you say is that if it's a fish that's managed by NOAA, that work is really being done for you, and that's not something that's on you to sort out on site.
Absolutely. I mean, 91% of our fisheries are not experiencing overfished, and over 85% are not overfished at all and fully rebuilt. So we know how to do this. We've got this. And we certainly have aquaculture.
We are so glad that healthcare professionals, doctors, dietitians, as well as just families, and we've seen so many retailers and restaurants, we're so glad that they're talking about sustainability. And seafood has such an important role in making our meals more sustainable.
It is really starting to take root and have a broader conversation in this country, mm-hmm. about sustainability and how it's done. Seafood has a great story to tell. I hope dietitians feel better and better about it because it's really going to be the blue planet protein that we need for the future and for our health.
Yeah, and that is the bottom line. We want this discussion to instill confidence in healthcare professionals as they recommend seafood and families as they eat seafood. We don't want this to be a barrier. When it comes to seafood, it is something that people should feel really good about sustainability-wise.
Yeah.
All right, well, thank you so much for joining me, Laurel.
Thanks, Jennifer.
I know that you are just a month or so away from retirement,
yeah.
And so we're so glad that we were able to catch you before you head out for the next phase of your life. Thank you for all you've done to help tell this story. And for more videos like this, please tune back in to our About Seafood YouTube channel.